Hey, let me show you how to use mClassic with Nintendo Switch, right? Got mClassic here. I'm gonna use the HDMI extender to make it easier, like that you will have a better fit in the back of the dock. I'm unplugging the HDMI cable from the Nintendo Switch adapter. I'm plugging the HDMI adapter provided with the mClassic, right? I'm plugging the mClassic in the HDMI extension cord that we provided. And now, set up. I'm getting the HDMI cable back into the back of mClassic. And since the graphics processor needs to be powered, I'm plugging the USB power cable in the back. Any USB port will get you the job. So I happen to have a 4K Samsung TV here. It's got a spare USB port. And now mClassic is connected. In default mode, it's full processing, the LED is green. What I'm gonna show you is in pass-through. I set up the Nintendo Switch in 720p since the graphics processor natively rendered into 720p resolution. As what we will be able to see, we'll be able to tell that this is the default, this is the setup of the Nintendo Switch. But as you can see, it's 720p resolution. Why? Because 720p in, it's mClassic is in pass-through mode. The LED is transparent, 720p is coming out. Now we get into full mode processing. I'm gonna switch. The LED turns green now. And what will we be able to notice is 720p is coming in inside the mClassic. I start to notice a serious enhancement, visual enhancement here, all the jaggies and edges and so on. And very quickly you'll be able to notice that now we went from 720p to 1080p full screen. In the case of full screen content, I could go into retro gaming mode. Since the aspect ratio is still 16:9 in that case, it doesn't change. It will still upscale it to 1920 by 1080. Thank you.